Welcome back to the Big Weekend Show. We've long said President Biden is to blame for the botched withdrawal in Afghanistan. Now the State Department agrees. A new report is condemning the Commander-in-Chief's decision during the withdrawal. But if you ask Biden, he insists he's done a good job. Take a listen.
Remember what I said about Afghanistan? I said Al-Qaeda would not be there. I said it wouldn't be there. I said we'd get help from the Taliban. What's happening now? What's going on? Read your press. I was right.
But according to his own State Department, there was insufficient senior-level consideration of worst-case scenarios and how quickly those might follow. Army Ranger Tim Kennedy slammed the Biden administration for attempting to cover up the severity of the withdrawal.
The Taliban were raping women in the street. They were beating people. They were dumping magazines into crowds as forms of crowd control. So, you know, not even but a month later, we effectively did an assassination of high-level Al-Qaeda in Kabul. So that makes no sense. He's obviously lying. And, you know, the timing of this release, the Department of State after-action review on the 4th of July weekend, you know, like not really saying much. It's so disingenuous to the American people. It's just another example of them trying to cover how horrible of a chaotic withdrawal that really was.
Well, it certainly was. Joey, I'm going to come to you, of course, on this. Being a member of the military and having sacrificed so much for our country, how does it make you feel when you read what that report said, when they said there was insufficient senior-level consideration of worst-case scenarios? Like, don't you think worst-case scenarios should always be on the forefront?
Those things were evident. The idea that they didn't plan for this and they were caught off guard was absolutely evident in the way things planned out. I didn't need the State Department to tell me that. This is like when your kid comes up and tells on themselves for something you saw them do. And that's about all that is. So this report, it's important because it will go into the records of history and it makes it that much harder to run away from it. But we saw in that clip how unashamed he will still absolutely run away from it. And that's what bothers me. I don't blame one single person for the withdrawal in Afghanistan going the way it did. I blame an administration. I blame four administrations, four different presidents who could not figure out a winning strategy in that country. I blame a voting populace who allowed people to tell them, hey, if you'll vote this way in this midterm, I'll fix it. If you'll vote this way in this presidential election, I'll fix it. And just keep doing the same thing over and over again without a different reaction. I blame all of us for what happened in Afghanistan. Maybe I could have done more when I was there to change the outcome of this war. But let me tell you who I do blame and what for. If you're the president of the United States, you've told 330 million people, I am a leader. I will hold myself accountable and I will be there for you. You let 13 service members die on what should not have been a battlefield. And your ask, in light of this report, were there mistakes? And you say, not only do you say there were no mistakes, but you say, hey, what happened? What I told you would happen. Well, Mr. President, what you told us would happen is that the Afghan government and the Afghan army would hold the line. You told us that for 2 weeks. And now you're telling us because Al-Qaeda isn't there to kill everybody and the Taliban has some sort of control of the country where you did a good job? Go to those 13 graves and tell them on this Independence Day how you did a good job and how you deserve a pat on the back. If you're going to lead this country and, most importantly, send men and women to war, hold yourself accountable and I'll vote for you. If the day after that he said, let me tell you, this is not the way it should. If he would have said, this is not the way it should go down, this is not the way it should be, and I'll dedicate the rest of my presidency to make sure this never happens again. Yep. He could have earned my vote. That's how important this is. And for him to act that way is the most dishonorable thing I've seen in regards to this specific issue in my life.
Well, Raymond, and Joey brings up a very valid and obviously passionate and emotional point. The fact that you have President Biden who is standing there when he's asked about that, he has the opportunity to talk about the mistakes and the devastations that ensued, but he does his creepy whisper, I'm right.
And your press.
This continues to go what has happened throughout the course of his administration. They don't take culpability for COVID, the vaccines, and all of these other things that have harmed Americans.
Joey is speaking for those 13 dead servicemen who didn't have to die. A chaotic situation, which didn't have to be this way, was created by this administration. Now they're admitting niggling mistakes like they didn't know who had the lead on the evacuation efforts. Well, that is mind-blowing. You don't know who has the lead? Senior officials didn't decide who was at risk, what Afghans were at risk, and who to airlift out. These are kind of major things if you're doing an evacuation of a country. They didn't do that. They failed not only our allies there, but most importantly, our servicemen. And they created an international chaos that has made us vulnerable on the world stage. All of that, he should take absolute, he should say, I am to blame for this. And I will take this step and this step to repair it. Joey's right. He didn't do that.
No, he did do that. And they released the report on the Friday before the July 4th weekend to bury it, Tammy.
On a Friday.
Well, you know, as we've discussed, everyone knew this. And yes, it's helpful to have this report in the history books, but no one will be held accountable. I think it's arguable that when it happened, I noted that this was not noise. It was a signal of what the Biden administration was about, which was incompetence, not planning, not caring to know or deal with it. And of course, now we have the Ukraine situation where every enemy and every ally made a judgment about this country at that point because they did what we're doing, which is, my goodness, we have the Taiwanese. It's like,
welcome back to the Big Weekend Show. We've long said President Biden is to blame for the botched withdrawal in Afghanistan. Now the State Department agrees. A new report is condemning the commander-in-chief's decision during the withdrawal. But if you ask Biden, he insists he's done a good job. Take a listen.
Remember what I said about Afghanistan? I said al-Qaeda would not be there. I said it wouldn't be there. I said we'd get help from the Taliban. What's happening now? What's going on? Read your press. I was right.
But according to his own State Department, there was insufficient senior-level consideration of worst-case scenarios and how quickly those might follow. Army Ranger Tim Kennedy slammed the Biden administration for attempting to cover up the severity of the withdrawal.
The Taliban were raping women in the street. They're beating people. They're dumping magazines into crowds as forms of crowd control. So, you know, not even but a month later, we effectively did an assassination of high-level Al-Qaeda in Kabul. So that makes no sense. He's obviously lying. And, you know, the timing of this release, the Department of State after-action review on the 4th of July weekend, you know, like not really saying much. It's so disingenuous to the American people. It's just another example of them trying to cover how horrible of a chaotic withdrawal that really was.
Well, it certainly was. Joey, I'm going to come to you, of course, on this. Being a member of the military and having sacrificed so much for our country, how does it make you feel when you read what that report said, when they said there was insufficient senior-level consideration of worst-case scenarios? Like, don't you think worst-case scenarios should always be on the forefront?
Those things were evident. The idea that they didn't plan for this and they were caught off guard was absolutely evident in the way things planned out. I didn't need the State Department to tell me that. This is like when your kid comes up and tells on themselves for something you saw them do. And that's about all that is. So this report, it's important because it will go into the records of history and it makes it that much harder to run away from it. But we saw in that clip how unashamed he will still absolutely run away from it. And that's what bothers me. I don't blame one single person for the withdrawal in Afghanistan going the way it did. I blame an administration. I blame four administrations, four different presidents who could not figure out a winning strategy in that country. I blame a voting populace who allowed people to tell them, hey, if you'll vote this way in this midterm, I'll fix it. If you'll vote this way in this presidential election, I'll fix it. And just keep doing the same thing over and over again without a different reaction. I blame all of us for what happened in Afghanistan. Maybe I could have done more when I was there to change the outcome of this war. But let me tell you who I do blame and what for. If you're the president of the United States, you've told 330 million people, I am a leader. I will hold myself accountable and I will be there for you. You let 13 service members die on what should not have been a battlefield. And your ask, in light of this report, were there mistakes? And you say, not only do you say there were no mistakes, but you say, hey, what happened? What I told you would happen. Well, Mr. President, what you told us would happen is that the Afghan government and the Afghan army would hold the line. You told us that for 2 weeks. And now you're telling us because Al-Qaeda isn't there to kill everybody and the Taliban has some sort of control of the country where you did a good job, Go to those 13 graves and tell them on this Independence Day how you did a good job and how you deserve a pat on the back. If you're going to lead this country, and most importantly, send men and women to war, hold yourself accountable, and I'll vote for you. If the day after that, he said, let me tell you, this is not the way it should, if he would have said, this is not the way it should go down, this is not the way it should be, and I'll dedicate the rest of my presidency to make sure this never happens again.
Yep.
He could have earned my vote. That's how important this is. Mm. And for him to act that way is the most dishonorable thing I've seen in regards to this specific issue in my life.
Well, Raymond, and Joey brings up a very valid and obviously passionate and emotional point. The fact that you have President Biden, who is standing there, when he's asked about that, he has the opportunity to talk about the mistakes and the devastations that ensued, but he does his creepy whisper, I'm right.
And read your press.
This continues to go what has happened throughout the course of his administration. They don't take culpability for COVID, the vaccines, and all of these other things that have harmed Americans.
Joey is speaking for those 13 dead servicemen who didn't have to die. A chaotic situation, which didn't have to be this way, was created by this administration. Now they're admitting niggling mistakes like they didn't know who had the lead on the evacuation efforts. Well, that is mind-blowing. You don't know who has the lead? They didn't make
Please
senior
join the
officials
conversation.
Didn't decide
Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section.
What Afghans were at
Thank
risk?
You for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MCAD TV family. Please like and share MCAD TV. We love you all. Please support MCAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.